It's time now to head into the chat room with Matthew Wolfrey and journalist Elle Halliwell. Good afternoon to both of you.
Hi, Emma.
Good afternoon.
Now, first up today, Facebook and Instagram have announced they'll ban all support of white nationalism and separatism on the social media sites in the wake of the Christchurch massacre. Now, while they've long banned hateful treatment based on race, they hadn't applied it to white nationalism. Let's go first to you, Matt. What do you think of this move?
I can't believe it. Isn't just racism racism? Why does it have to be separated into... We have to specifically ban this white fascism and stuff like that online. I can't believe that this isn't already happening. We talked about this earlier in the week about, you know, this Facebook, how it should have the ability to stop these videos going out there. We know that they have the ability to track ads with us, so ads and advertising, so they can 100% do this. And I'm just so surprised that there has to be clarity here. Why can't they just ban all racial things and it be like that from the get-go? I'm really surprised.
Elle, there was a lot of criticism of Facebook after the Christchurch killings were streamed live, and they were kept up on their site for over an hour. Is what they've done now at least a step in the right direction?
Yeah, look, I absolutely think so. I think that they really have a strong moral obligation to do that and to stop the spreading of hate. And I think that, you know, as a community, both online and, you know, in real life, we also need to do this too. And look, in my opinion, if you wanted to preach, you know, white nationalism at home or to your mates in the pub, that's a different kettle of fish. You can do that in the privacy of your... That's none of my business. But look, if you're going to be doing this on a platform that is exposed to, you know, millions and millions of impressionable young people, it's simply not on. So I think that it's absolutely about time that this has happened.
We talked about how Facebook and social media have got to catch up with the rules that other media are exposed to as well. And I think this is really important there, that it is a platform. People can broadcast their views to a wide amount of people. So it needs to be held to account in the exact same way that television stations, newspapers, radios all get held together with their media standards as well. It is a form of media now.
But what about censorship, Matt? Do you worry that, you know, we're censoring too much?
I don't think it's censorship when it's a racism that you're talking about here, because you shouldn't be that shouldn't be allowed. It is illegal, you know what I mean? So it's not censorship to stop people spruiking something that is hateful and illegal. If you have opinions, that's different to really spruiking them and saying hurtful things online. There's a big difference there, I think.
Yeah, I agree, and I think they should go further and really clamp down on bullying while they're at it. Supermarket MULI-BUY officer making us fat, apparently, with a third of food and drink bought through a promotion. Now, the discounts and deals are boosting the amount of junk food that we consume while cutting down on the fruit and veggies that we buy, because they're rarely on sale. Elle, do you get sucked into the buy one, get one free deals?
Not so much as I used to, although if they've got kale on special, you know, three for $5, oh, I'm right there. No, but look, I mean, there's been so much research on kind of linking low socioeconomic status with obesity, and I think that this kind of study, you know, shows this, but I think it also offers us a really great solution to, you know, one part of the obesity crisis, which is why don't we pressure supermarkets to stop offering these MULI-BUY products when it comes to foods that are high in fat, foods that are high in sugar, highly processed, and start, you know, offering really great, you know, three for the price of one deals on things like bananas and healthy fruit and vegetables.
Is the onus on supermarkets, Matt, or is it on the individual?
No, see, I don't think that we should be stopping the discounts and all these naughty things. Why not get them for a good deal? But I do agree with you that it needs to be going on the things that are good for you. So why not do two pieces of broccoli for special and, you know, multiple avocados and plenty of kale at a cheaper price? I think that's where you're going to get people to eat better rather than necessarily taking away all the bad stuff altogether. And you know what? I am a sucker for those chocolate bar specials on the way out of the counter. I yes. will always pick up a little Mars bar or a Snickers and I'm good to go.
And let's be honest, like if you've got three Tim Tams for the price of one, you've got three packets of Tim Tams in your house, you're going to eat all of those Tim Tams, aren't you?
You are.
You are, but I fall for it all the time. I love a good deal. I love a good deal.
Me too.
Whether it's on points or it's three for one or
I wouldn't
whatever.
Even want a packet of Tim Tams, but if they're on sale, I probably would end up buying them. So they got me.
Oh, they got me too. All right, lastly today, from shoulder pads to tie-dye and perms, many of us have been through fads and phases that we now look at with regret. A new poll suggests as many as 66% of us have a fashion regret, with hairstyles by far the biggest regret factor. Matt, do you have any fashion regrets?
What regrets don't I have when it comes to my fashion? My big one has been my glasses, because I've had glasses as I've grown up and the styles have changed. I started off with round Harry Potter style glasses, and then for a while there I went through transition lenses, which just made them look like halfway between sunglasses and normal glasses in school photos. My school photo catalogue is just a whole series of regrets of hairstyles and glasses that I look back now on and shake my head. But you know what? They're fun to laugh at, and I enjoy looking back at them and going, what was I thinking?
Oh, I wore glasses in school too, and I had these bright electric blue pair that I still think are quite fabulous. Elle, what about you? Fashion regrets?
You know what? Like, most of the time, I think it's maybe because I've worked in fashion for so long, my wardrobe is pretty much black, so I haven't had too many, but I've had more beauty disasters. I've had some terrible hair extension moments, terrible fake tan, but the great thing about being over 30 is most of my fashion crimes are collecting dust underneath my staircase in an old photo album. God forbid I was born, you know, 10 years later and had it all splashed all over the internet.
I know, right. Thank God there was no social media when we grew up, because I can say to my parents, if those photos come out, I'll kill you.
Well, when we were doing this segment, I thought, oh, has anyone got photos? But they're just not easy to find. You have to go into the basement and look them up. I can thank
That's
my mother
like
for
it.
One fashion aversion. I desperately wanted a spiral perm when I was young. Desperate. I begged for this spiral perm. She would not let me get it year after year, and I'm so grateful that she did. But a few other fashion regrets, I don't know, Levi's 501s at like really high-waisted, they were always great. Oh, I don't know.
I had button-up snap pants, which were really big when I was growing up, which just walked around with your thigh exposed. I don't know why.
Gotta leave it there on that note. Thank you, Elle and Matt, so much for being on Chat Room.